Okay, today we are playing a game on Lijiang Tower. We are playing Reinhardt the entire way through, and I don't know the exact SR of this game, but I've been informed it is in the platinum range somewhere. Probably on the higher end based on, like, the borders, but I don't know exactly. So, let's look at our team. We've got triple tank, which is still perfectly fine. Still works. Would prefer, however, if we have triple tank, if our DPS was someone other than Genji. Genji, not exactly a consistent DPS. I would prefer if he was playing someone like Soldier. Also, he has the gold emblem, so I wouldn't exactly expect him to be a pro Genji. But, you know, whatever, that's fine. Would also prefer if Mercy was playing Ana instead, just because Ana works very well with triple tank in general, even after the nerf. And there's not really a great person for Mercy to, like, damage amp on our team. Like, the best she's got is gonna be, like, Zarya or Roadhog, but she can at least farm a res really fast off of the triple tank, so there's that, at least. Lucio, always good, of course, and our three tanks are pretty much the best tanks that you could pick, really. Well, Zarya could be D.Va, but D.Va significantly less good after being nerfed. So, let's start the game and skip forward a little bit, since we have a bit of prep time and walking to go through. Okay, so our team is blasting off ahead of us. That's because we stopped to, like, look at the team chat thing. We pushed P right at the start, so we're lagging a little bit behind, which isn't great. We want to be at the front as Reinhardt, but it's whatever. So now we've got the fight. This is why Reinhardt is less good on King of the Hill, just because the fights tend to be coming at you from multiple angles. Less so on Control Tower, but, like, this is a bit of an example of it, where, like, we're having this fight up here, but then this fight is breaking out down here as well, and Reinhardt prefers if he only has to, like, focus in one direction at a time, rather than having to split focus like this, but the enemy team does fall back and start grouping through this way anyway. Now, Roadhog's gotten picked off, which is absolutely terrible for them. We don't really need to have our barrier up right now, because there's no one behind us, and we're not blocking any damage right now either, so this is time it could be regenerating. And we hold it on 940 for a really long time, and, like, look, there's no one behind us, we're not taking any damage at all. When there's no damage going around, you're not protecting anyone, just take your barrier down, let it recharge, because you gotta manage your barrier really carefully. Especially on King of the Hill, where there tends to be less breathing space to let your shield actually recharge. Like, our shield could be at full HP right now if we'd been letting it recharge this entire time, but it's, like, a quarter of the way dead. And, like, now we just gotta now we really just have to take the shield down and, like, let it regenerate. We're blocking off this Genji with it right here, which is, of course, perfectly fine. We do want to protect people from Mei when they get frozen, but, like, our shield's getting dangerously close to breaking when it could be, like, close to full HP. So that's some poor shield management right there. And now a fight's breaking out, and it's again gonna be really difficult for us just because their team isn't, like, great for us, because, like, they have a Roadhog and, like, a Winston and a Zarya, a Mei. It's really awkward for Reinhardt to fight this kind of team just because, like, Roadhog's gonna break the shield really fast. Mei is just gonna, like, try and dance around us a lot of the time, and, like, you know, hopefully our team helps us with that, but our DPS is Genji, so we have to rely on, like, Roadhog to make sure Mei doesn't start bullying us. And Winston's just gonna stand there and, like, tase through our shield, so it's a bit of an unfortunate team to be playing Reinhardt against, and, like, now this is gonna happen. And there's, like, not much we can do to get help when Mei is doing this, because, like, we only really have Roadhog to help us, but if he doesn't notice or his hook's on cooldown, not much we can do. Now, I don't really like this charge here that much, just because, like, what realistically are we expecting to get? I guess we're hoping to get Mei, but she goes off way on the side, and we don't commit fully to pinning the Roadhog that we could have pinned, because I think we've regretted pushing shift right as we did it. Genji was going around with the Dragon Blade, so it wouldn't have been so terrible to charge him, but, you know, charging in as Reinhardt does have a tendency to get you killed unless you have a really good reason to doing it, and I don't think we had a really good reason to do it there. I think we could have just sort of stood back, held our shield up, because, like, yeah, Mei was bullying us, but she wasn't about to kill us anytime soon. So now, again, our shield's getting really close to breaking. We really just need to be letting it regen during this point. And this is, like, an example of a really bad Reinhardt charge, because, like, Lucio earth barriers, I was about to say. Lucio drops the bead, and we're like, oh, well, I guess we're gonna go in. We charge at basically no one. Like, we basically look over there and just kind of go, I'll charge over there and hope someone gets in the way. We whiff completely. Now we're surrounded, and we don't retreat very well either, because we retreat down this alleyway rather than just going back across the point. And, like, now we're right in the enemy team's face. This wall over here is blocking line of sight to our healers, so they can't even, like, it's hard for our team to support us because this is blocking us off. We could have just ran, like, straight, like, gone back across the point like so, and it would have been much easier to retreat. So we charged in poorly to begin with, and then we've boxed ourselves into an even worse position after that. And now, like, there's no way realistically we get out. We try and do a little bit of barrier hopping, but it just doesn't work out. Roadhog just pushes in and kills us. So a bit of a poor engage there. I think you felt obligated to go in because of the sound barrier, but like you could have just sort of sat back and like held the barrier up. It would have been perfectly fine. Now Genji's just killed McCree with his own High Noon, so that's always funny to see. Genji killed McCree with High Noon. So now our team is getting pretty fucked up right now. Like, we could have saved this Lucio's life right here, because he doesn't get killed immediately. We, like, do this Earth Shad, this Fire Strike at the Bazaria. If we just sort of... it's a bit awkward, but if we turn sort of right, we just pivot a little bit to the right and hold the barrier up as we get close to him. I think we could have just about clipped the shield in front of him before the headshot kills him, because we get there, like... basically immediately as he dies. So if we were angled like this and just put the shield up as we approached him, I think we could have just about saved him, but it was going to be very close. The fire striking at the Zarya, though, definitely, like, not helpful. Now, we're getting bullied around by Mei, and it's really difficult for us to deal with Mei, but, like, we should have been focusing this Mei a little bit sooner, because she's trying to bully our Mercy right now. Like, we're looking over here, fire striking into them. Mei's just walked right past us, and she's starting to bully the Mercy. We switch eventually, but, like, as soon as someone starts approaching our Mercy, that's pretty much our top priority as Reinhardt. So with a little bit of a delayed reaction, Mercy gets away, though, so it's perfectly fine. She shifts over us. And now, I'm not sure why we're playing so far back right now, because our barrier is, like, mostly full. Like, we go back here and, like, we let it recharge a little bit, but, like, we could be, like, up at the front right now. Like, our team is pushing in without us, and our barrier is, like, was very close to full HP during this entire time. So, not sure why we were playing so far back so cautiously right there. I've upset you too. And, like, right now, like, we're sitting on Fire Strike right now as well. Like, we're sitting on Fire Strike when we only have to hit one more person and we'll get Earth Shatter off of it. So we really want to, like, Fire Strike into them a lot sooner than this, just so we can have Earth Shatter as quickly as possible. Because, like, this could be a full Earth Shatter right now, and, like, Earth Shattering just those two people there would have been not terrible. So now we're coming in, the Mei wall's in the way, it's a bit awkward. This is a good Earth Shatter, but it's a shame we didn't do it just slightly sooner. Because if we did it just a little bit sooner, like right around here, we would have gotten the Mercy as well. So like we get their entire team, and then like, but we don't get Mercy. And then we don't focus the Mercy either, because Mercy's, like, gone around this corner, and, like, we can see her bat, like, her beam this entire time, so we know exactly where she is. We also saw her go around the corner, but, you know, whatever. And, like, imagine what she sees right now. This must look like a scene from a horror movie from Mercy's perspective, because she sees her team gets earth-shattered, and then Reinhardt just walks past the corner and, like, doesn't even acknowledge her a little bit. Like... yeah, we want to be going into the mass of people and, like, swinging into them, obviously. But, like, it doesn't do any good if Mercy's still alive, because she's just going to res them. So we need to, like, turn around the corner and just start trying to kill the Mercy, honestly. Because, like, our team's focusing them over here anyway. Like, we don't even really take part in that kill that much. So we need to be just turn around the corner and get the Mercy. Rather than doing this. Because, like, even if we kill those three people, Mercy will just res them. Slightly too early on the charge there, unfortunate. And, like, now this is like, we're overextending on this chase right here, just because, like, we're pushing into a Mei. Like, we don't want to get walled off and frozen right in front of their team, so we overextend a little bit there. Like, McCree was there as well, so, like, if Mei walled us off, like, right around there, that would have been really unfortunate, and her wall was getting pretty close to being off cooldown by that point, so we overextend a little bit. We're overextending a little bit now just because we can see Roadhog there, but we're trying to, like, get the two healers, so I don't hate it, and it's not like Roadhog's gonna immediately kill us, so that's less terrible since Mei was also dead. But then, like, we fall back really far for, like, no real reason right here. Like, we go back around this barrier. Like, we go back around the center here, even though, like, we don't need to go back around there. Like, our barrier is at full HP. We're at full HP. We don't need to come this far back. We could stay, like, further up the front. Like, obviously, we don't want to keep pushing in, like, towards the doorway. But we could be standing sort of in this range, like, this it range right around here, just so that we're, like, preventing people from walking onto the point. And, like, if we were standing right there, like, Lucio wouldn't get hooked right here. And, like, miraculously he lives, because Zarya gets, like, a very clutch bubble onto him, and he gets the sound barrier. But, like, we should have been up here, like, preventing Roadhog from walking onto the point, because there was no reason for us to fall back. So, like, he didn't need to get hooked at all. And now we're, like, beating up on this Roadhog, but, like, it's really hard for Reinhardt to really make much progress beating up on a Roadhog. Like, if we're not gonna commit to trying to pin him, this is just, like, a waste of time to be hitting into him. Our time would be better spent either holding up the barrier in front of him so he can't shoot our teammates while we're fighting him, or we just turn around and, like, hold the barrier up against the rest of the team and, like, trust that our team is gonna kill this Roadhog who is in way too deep right now. Like, us swinging into him is not really achieving anything. And we whiff our charge here, like, unfortunate, and now we're getting bullied around by Mei and Zarya, and it's just kind of really unfortunate all around, because, like, again, we don't have anyone that can really help us. So rather than swinging into this Roadhog, I would have liked if we were just holding up the barrier, basically. And, like, right there, it actually looks like we're trying to charge Roadhog, but he dies, like, right as we start the charge, so, yeah, like, I think that's what happened anyway. So I would have preferred if we were just holding the barrier up, and then we charge forward into their team, and now we're too far forward. These two are just going to start bullying us because we charge too far forward. Our team can't save us from this, and we're basically fucked. So that's all very unfortunate. Silver lining, we do almost have Earth Shatter. Like, we don't have to do much work to get Earth Shatter up right now. Now, our team dies over there, as you would expect, seeing as all the ultimates started flying around, so we have to wait around out here for our team to get back. That's good. I don't like how much we look over at the enemy spawn while at our spawn while this is happening, just because, like, we stand out in the open basically the entire time, like, looking back at our team. And, like, there's a Roadhog and a Mei on the enemy team, right? Like, if we don't want to get hooked into them, and we just turn our back to the enemy team the entire time. So I'd prefer if we were just, like, looking over here or standing less in the open during that time. But, like, you know, it's like you weren't probably not going to get punished for that, but it's something you can get punished for and you really don't want to. So, again, now, during here, we have Fire Strike. And we are 10% away from having full charge, so we want to Fire Strike, like, right now, because, like, there's a bunch of people grouped up over here, and we want to get Earth Shatter, like, as soon as possible, because we're about to engage a fight. And, like, we're pushing in. Our team's not quite with us now they're coming in. Now, Mei's walled off behind us, so we do have to be really careful now that we don't end up committing to a bad fight while our team can't get to us, because she walls us off right around here. And it doesn't look like it's fully blocking the door. No, it's not. And most of our team came through with us. Now, Zarya gets hooked over here, and, like, this is, like, not your fault, because you're, like, letting the shield recharge, but, like, Zarya just stands around in the open, gets hooked, and, like, quality has just gone, like, tits up right now, so let's just fix that really quick. Come on, YouTube. There we go. So, now let's go back a little bit, since, like, stuff happened while we were doing that. So, okay, so this happens, all this happens, and now, like, it's a shame we don't have Earth Shatter right now, because we could... Of course, yes, Bear with me one moment while we wait for the internet to work again. Okay, we seem to be good again. So, now, again, we could Fire Strike into these people really, like, a lot sooner than this, and, like... It's a shame we don't have Earth Shatter right now, because, like, this is pretty much the perfect time to Earth Shatter right around here, right? Like, right as we see the Graviton go down, we'd like to just Earth Shatter across their entire team. But we end up getting it late, we come in, we start swinging into them as we do, and May drops the blizzard down. Now, there's a few things I'm not too happy with here. First off, we could have Earth Shatter right as this started, but we've already talked about that. But then, like, so it all happens. Earth Shatter, like, the Graviton goes in and we start swinging. We go around the enemy team, which I'm not a big fan of, because, like, they're going to be firing into our team as they're, like, out of the Graviton, they're going to be firing into our team. So, like, we should really be standing on the front so that as we're swinging into them, we can, like, body block for our team as they follow up. So I don't like that we swing around the back of them, because it's not like this is making us do any more damage or anything like that, right? So I'm not happy with that. And then when we hear May use Blizzard, we react really, really late to it. Like, we needed to start charging away a lot sooner than that, because she throws it right at her feet. So basically, as soon as we hear the line, we need to charge away so that we don't get frozen. I also, since we didn't have Earth Shatter right as this happened, I would have charged right into it, because, like, Roadhog gets hooked out of the way, but we want to get Roadhog out of the way of the enemy team, and, like, charging a Roadhog is, like, half his hit points immediately gone. So as soon as I saw the Graviton go down and I don't have Earth Shatter, I would have just charged into them. Basically trying to get Roadhog out of the way so that the team can focus down the more important members of the enemy team, like, you know, Lucio, Mercy, May, all that. So I don't like many aspects of this right here, and it all just ends up being very unfortunate. But silver lining, we still have Earth Shatter, Mercy still has Rez, and Roadhog still has Whole Hog. We don't know what anyone else is at right now, other than obviously Zarya has nothing, because she just ulted. So, and they used a lot of ults right there. Well, okay, they used Blizzard, but, like, you know, like, Blizzard is a really big ultimate for them. Like, that's how, like, that and Whole Hog are how they're gonna stop and engage a lot of the time. Or the Graviton, so, I guess, so. Hey, you know what, never mind. You know what, never mind what I was saying right there. I don't know what I'm talking about is the moral of that story. So, Tracer is trying to heckle us right now, and we're, like, trying to swing at the Tracer. Don't even bother, just, like, start trying to, like, if she's not gonna kill anyone, just, like, start walking forward with your shield up again. Because, like, she wasn't doing anything there, she was just kind of being annoying in the back line, and there's not a lot we can do about it. So, we're looking to Earth Shatter the enemy team right now, and this is pretty much the perfect Earth Shatter right now. We've gotten a lot of their important members of their team, but again, Mercy's positioning very well, she's off to the side, we end up not getting her with Earth Shatter, so we kind of have to focus her again. Like, our team is going to focus down these people that we just hit. Though we get the Lucio, that's great, but, like, Mercy's just gonna res these people. Like, it doesn't do us any good to kill these people, because Mercy is just gonna res them. So as soon as we Earth Shatter and we see we didn't get Mercy, we should just swing over there and start getting the Mercy. Because she's sitting over there, like, completely unpestered right now, just, like, having the time of her life, and just waits for the res. Again, misalign, like, this is a bad charge, because, like... Okay, there we go. So this is a bad charge, because, like, we charge, like, May's not gonna come out of this right there. We end up, like, missing her anyway, and, like, we end up abandoning our team to do that while, like, a Roadhog and a May are, like, near our team, and Azaria are near our team. So we, like, charge away from our team and don't really do anything with it, which is not great. But we're winning the fight at this point. It's looking pretty unlikely that we're gonna lose the fight, and Tracer's coming back. She's gonna try. Roadhog's ulting just to keep her away. Block the pulse bomb, great. Tracer doesn't come back in time, we end up winning the round, great. All works out in the end. Overall, not a bad round, not too happy with, like, how we were. We didn't prioritize our ult charge very well, and I don't think we chose our targets very well after we ulted. There was a really prime example in this round of not having proper prioritization after we ult, but we'll get to that when we come to it, which is a little bit later on, obviously, because we're in the spawn. It's not like we're going to ult anyone right now, so obviously it's a little bit later on. So, he switched to Soldier, switched back to Genji. That's upsetting. Would still rather have a Soldier, especially on this map, which has a really high tendency for the enemy team to have a Pharah on it. So a little bit of miscommunication here. We want to go over that way, but our team wants to go over this way. We end up getting walled off from most of our team. This is a really risky maneuver, just because, like, you could try and jump over that rock and slide off. We could get, like, booped off by, like, a bunch of people, so I'd rather just wait. Like, seeing as we couldn't get around that wall easily, we should probably just wait for it to fall instead of just, like, trying to force our way past the side and risk falling off. So, now, we've managed to get back to our team before anyone's died. That's great. This is a really good charge. Perfectly timed. Get her right there. Great. swing into the Zarya. She's getting away with it. Like, and now we've got both the healers right there. We start swinging into them. It's not really working out. Our team is starting to lose the fight behind us. Oh, fuck a Reaper. Reaper's like, oh, fuck Reinhardt. We actually almost have Earth Shatter. This is not a very good Earth Shatter because we only get Lucio. I think the intent was to also get Zarya because she was right in front of us. Like, if we watch again, she was like right in front of us when we started it. But like, that kind of range, like, Earth Shatter is a really thin ultimate directly in front of Reinhardt. Like, it's basically just like that. Like, it's kind of like that. It's really thin on top of Reinhardt, and then it like balloons out very fast. So it's, like, really hard to hit someone in that kind of range, because they only have to move, like, a foot and get out of the way. So it's not great that we tried to get the Zarya as well, and we end up only getting Lucio with it. Which is not the end of the world, because Lucio's, like, being hard to kill. We end up killing the Lucio, but then I don't like what we do after that, because we get Lucio, we go in, we swing into Lucio, great. We see Zarya is over here. Let me get the... if I can, like, get this to cooperate with me. Zarya is over here bullying Mercy. Mercy's almost dead. Lucio's half HP. He's getting healed, but, like, Mercy's almost dead, and Zarya is got her sights dead set on this Mercy. Like, we need to put the shield up and just protect Mercy right there. And as we can see, not long after, Mercy dies. We could have tried to save her from the Zarya, because what we're doing instead is we're, like, chasing after people, which is not really our job as Reinhardt. Like... especially not on a team that's, like, got a Genji on it, like Genji, Zarya, Roadhog, you know? It's not our job to go chasing after the enemy team like this. We should just be like, we get the Lucio and that's fine, but then we need to start protecting the Mercy because we can see her getting bullied around. Like, our job as Reinhardt is to protect people, not dive after the enemy team. And, like, we end up not really doing very much chasing after them, we just, like, leave Mercy out in the lurch. So we missed the charge there, that's unfortunate, this Roadhog's, like, getting bullied around, but again, we've, like, left our team behind to do this, like, this whole time we've been chasing after the enemy team, but, like, Zarya's been in the back line hitting people, Reaper's back there now hitting people, like, we need to be back there protecting them from, like, the Zarya and the Reaper, rather than chasing after people, because, like, it's just, it's not what we're meant to be doing as Reinhardt, we're meant to be protecting people. Like, obviously, yeah, we're supposed to engage fights if we get, like, nano-boosted or something like that, but in this kind of situation, we just need to be protecting our back line from the people diving onto them. And, like, we end up just leaving them behind to die, and we end up losing the point. It's very unfortunate. Now, again, I don't like that we're just, like, staring over there, especially since our team is over here. Like, we could be standing over here with our team, just, like, have the barrier in front of them, like, trying to get, like, some damage in, charging ults and all that. And, like, we turn our back to the enemy team, and, like... there's a gap over there, and there's an enemy Roadhog, so, like, we're just kind of asking to get hooked into the pit blindly. So, not a fan of that. So, we come over here, we see people getting frozen, we put the shield up, great, we're trying to block this Reaper now, that's good, he ults, not a very good ult. Very, very brave charge, I don't think I would have done that, because I would have been really afraid of just, like, bumping the wall slightly and falling off, but we get the Mei, that's great. Like... I don't like that response to seeing the Zarya getting hooked, because we see her get hooked, and, like, our response is to fire strike. My response would be to get in between the Zarya and the Roadhog and just put the shield up, because he gets one shot right into her. If he shoots her again, she dies, so my thought would have been to put the shield between Zarya and Roadhog so that she doesn't die. We take the barrier down right at the end there, which is really risky because we're right next to an edge. Don't take the barrier down against Whole Hog when you're next to an edge, really asking to die. But it all works out. Genji goes in with the Dragon Blade, gets some work done, so now we've got control of the point. Great. And we see from pushing tab, we have Graviton and Whole Hog, so we're pretty set for the next fight as well, assuming both of those ultimates go off properly. So we're standing over here, which is... not terrible. Like, this is perfectly fine to be standing over here. But when I'm playing Reinhardt on this map, and I have a Roadhog, and the Roadhog's standing over in this kind of area, I actually like to come and stand in front of the Roadhog, because then Roadhog can stand behind your barrier over here, and he's got, like, he can just stand there and try to hook people over the edge, like, and your team can, like, stand over here and fire over this way as well. It's perfectly fine. But then you give Roadhog, like, complete safety to try and, like, hook over the enemy Roadhog. He can try and just, like, get a cheesy hook kill in on someone. And, like, standing over there is kind of the same as standing over here. Standing over here is, like, a little more risky because, like, you're right next to an edge, so you can get bumped off over here. But I like to stand over here just so, like, Roadhog can try and get a little bit more work done. But this is also fine. So enemy team's going around this way, which is pretty much the best way you can go. And, like, this is a much better way to approach the point than across the bridge, so that's fine. Now, we charge into the enemy team here when we see all the ultimates flying, and I'm not entirely sold on that being the correct course of action, because, like, we see the blizzard come out. Like, we see the graviton. We see the blizzard. Like, we could just fall back, because, like, the enemy team is going to come in really hard right now, because, like, they drop the beat, the blizzard's coming in, Reaper's dashing through us. Like, because their beat has dropped as well, like, we're not going to kill anybody by pinning them. And I think we actually charge before we hear the drop of the beat, so that's, like, disregard that. That's not relevant. But, like, we know the enemy team is going to start coming in because they've dropped the blizzard, and we see Reaper, like, coming forward with them. Like, we should rather than charging in like this, we should probably just be falling back to, like, protect our team. And it's, like, the enemy team gets caught up like that, right, with the graviton. Even disregarding everything else, with the team, like, grouped up, like, the whole enemy team basically is getting grouped up like this. Because there is, like, this narrow area the team has to advance through to actually start firing into the enemy team, like, it's better if we were just standing here holding the barrier up in front of the door so that our team can, like, just shoot into the enemy team unobstructed. Because, like, their team has a lot of things that are really scary to walk into, right? Because they have a Mei, they have a Reaper, they have a Roadhog. Like, there's a lot of threatening things over here, so it's probably better if we just stand here. Like, even disregarding everything else that happens here, it's probably still better to just hold the barrier up in front of the doorframe just so our team can, like, fire in unobstructed. And, like, we know Roadhog's gonna whole hog into the enemy team as well, because we can see that that was off cooldown, or that was charged up, rather. So, and we don't want him to get, like, CC'd, right? We don't want him to just get hooked immediately and end up getting it interrupted. So we can just stand in front of the Roadhog with the barrier and let him fire into the enemy team completely unobstructed. Instead, we, like, charge in ourselves, and, like, we'd end up not getting a lot done with it. Like, now here, we actually do manage to Earthshatter the enemy Mercy. Like, we end up over here and we Earthshatter three people. We then see, we hit Mercy. We think about going over to Mercy, and then we don't go over to Mercy. We have to go over and get the Mercy, because again, it doesn't do us any good if we kill people and Mercy's still alive, because she is just gonna res everyone. And again, because we've charged in and left our team behind, Reaper and Zarya have managed to kill people on our team, because, like, Reaper just floated past, and, like, now Reaper is, like, doing a lot of work over there. We could be over there, like, protecting Reaper. Like, we could have, like, we'd have Earth Shatter probably, because we charged it up, like, immediately upon ending that pin. So, like, swinging into the team over here, swinging into the people bullying our team, we'd have Earth Shatter as well. So we could, like, Earth Shatter these people, like, just block for our team. Like, we've left our team behind again, and, like, they're getting kind of fucked up by it. And, like, us being over here doesn't really do anything. Like, we keep Mei preoccupied, but Mei already used Blizzard, so her contribution has basically, like, been made at that point, right? Like, yeah, she's not around there, like, freezing people faster or getting headshots, but us holding Mei over there doesn't really do anything when we could have been standing over here just, like, blocking for our team. There is this thing with Reinhardt where it's really easy to get into the mindset, like, oh, you see, like, Graviton or something, and you're like, oh, I'm gonna go in there and start swinging into them, and, like, you know, having a great time, I'll, like, charge into it, things like that. And, like, that's fine in, like, a lot of circumstances, especially if you're, like, pinning the tank out of the way, right? Like, there's, like, a Reinhardt or a Roadhog blocking in the Graviton, you just pin them out of the way, that's great, then your team can, like, focus down the squishier people in there. But, like, it's not always the play to make either, because, like, a lot of the time, the best play you can make with Reinhardt is just holding the barrier up so that your team can get more damage in, right? Like, even the first Graviton, where I was saying I would have charged into it to get Roadhog out of the way, it would have been perfectly fine there to just hold the barrier up in front of the team as well, and just let our team fire into it unobstructed. Actually, less so there, because our barrier was, like, mostly broken at the time that happened as well, wasn't it? Disregard that point. I don't know, I'm all over the place today. I keep thinking about things, and then I'm like, wait, no, I'm wrong about that. But, like, so, like, right over there, like, we just want to block for our Roadhog and our team more than anything, because it's not like there's a tank in the Graviton, like, blocking for their team or anything. We could have just made sure our team was perfectly safe and they can fire into everything. And then we could have protected our teammates from Reaper and Zarya when they came in. We still won the fight, so in the end, it's all, like, how much can you really complain if you win the fight? But I think it would have been better in that situation if we were just blocking for the enemy team. So now the enemy team's coming in like this, May's trying to bully us, but it's a lot harder to do from that position, so we're getting away with it a lot more. That, like, we get, this May is really fucking sad. Like, May keeps getting pinned by us, so she's probably getting pretty tilted right about now. That's a really good fire strike, we end up getting Mercy. We run down the Roadhog, great. Fight goes pretty much as well as you can expect it to. Just, like, a really poorly, like, coordinated engage from the enemy team. Like, May's coming in ahead of everybody. May gets pinned because she's, like, up on the front line. You know, it's not great all around. So now, this is exactly what I would have done in this position as well. Because, I would have definitely done this Earth Shatter as well. But, like, I also know this is not what we should do in this situation because that happens. And, like, we know Mercy, like, has res, because we haven't seen her use it in a little while, and it also charges really fucking fast, right? And, like, I would have done this, because I would have been like, oh, these people are going to the point, it's about to go into overtime, I'll ult them. And, like, if the Lucio didn't get on the point, it would have actually worked out perfectly fine. But I also know we didn't need to Earth Shatter these people, right? Like, this is an unnecessary Earth Shatter at the same time, because, like, it's Lucio and May, and we are all here right now. Like, we don't need to Earth Shatter like that, because we can just, like, beat these people up, because they're running in, like, by themselves, right? So, we didn't need to Earth Shatter there. I would have absolutely done the same thing in that position, but I know that it, like, watching it, I know that it wasn't the correct play either, because we could have just killed them, like, without Earth Shattering. So, now we pin Roadhog. Great. Unfortunately, we've pinned Roadhog really far away from the enemy team. From our team, rather. We wanted to pin him far away from the enemy team. We've pinned him really far away from our team, and we're at half hit points. So he just shoots into us and goes, oh, you fucked up now. We actually do a really good job of kiting away from him. Like, that's some really good barrier hopping right there. Like, pretty much the best you can ask for in that situation. But we run out of platform, so we're pretty fucked at the end of that. Like, so if we go all the way back, like, we get hooked, like, just hold the barrier up, right? Like, we don't, like, there's no way this works out for us if we pin him, right? Because we're, like, half hit points, we're pinning him really far away from our team. If we're gonna do this, we basically have to go over the edge with him, because pinning him, we are definitely gonna die. I don't think we should go for the charge at all. We should just hold the barrier up, especially since our barrier is at, like, full hit points when we do this. Like, it is at full hit points. So this is an unnecessary charge, and it ends up actually getting us killed. Because we run out of platform. We make the best out of it with the hopping away, but, like, we basically signed our own death warrant right there. So now, it's hard to tell what's happening, because we're watching this Genji, but it looks like our team is doing okay. Roadhog is actually doing, like, a fucking lot of work right now and has, like, killed half their team by himself. Reaper's coming in. We're actually back now, so that's okay. We just start swinging into the enemy team. We're just swinging in. Playing Reinhardt, just wiggling around, swinging into people. That's fine. Don't think we should be holding the barrier up in this situation. I think we just want to be, like, getting these people off since these are, like, the stragglers in the fight. Winston throws himself out the window. They end up losing the round. Don't think he meant to throw himself out the window. I think he was just kind of trying to jump away from people on the point, but he ended up going out the window, so that's unfortunate for him. So, now. Not much time left in this game. This is the last round. Only goes 3 rounds. Doing a little bit of bonding with our team. And now, we still have the same team, but that's fine. Like, it's been working out for us so far. No reason to really change anything, I guess. Like, do you really want to be playing Genji into Azaria and a Mei and, like, a Roadhog? Not really, but, like, you know, whatever. I guess it's still working out. And to be fair, Genji's gotten a few good Dragon Blades off, so it's okay. Even though, you know, we'd rather have a lot of other things. So we're pushing in with our team. This is fine. We kind of leave Mercy behind a little bit right there. Like, she doesn't quite get through the doorway when we start coming around. Now she's like, now the, this really scattered fight is happening. Like, Genji is having, like, an awful time right now, because the whole team just dives directly onto his face, and he's just like, oh god, please get me out. And, like, they have a Winston now as well. Right, of course, someone changed to Winston right near the end, so... Like, he's playing Genji into a lot of Genji counters. Like, Mercy flies right into our face, and but it's like, we couldn't really do that much to punish her for it, and we're also really surprised it happens. Like, she's like, whoa, whoa. And by the time we even, like, realize she's there, she's already gone. Some wonder if she was ever even there to begin with. Now, we're barrier hopping away right there again. And, like, the thing is, barrier hopping is a lot less effective against Reaper, because Reaper fires significantly faster than Roadhog does. So this is actually leading to us taking a lot of damage, because if you watch your health bar, like, let's slow it down a little bit so we can see it a little more clearly. Like, so, this happens. I've gone back a little bit far for this to be going this slow, but, like, so Reaper starts coming at us, and we start barrier hopping away. We take it down, he gets a shot into us, it's not much, then he shoots into us again, then he shoots into us again, then he's gonna shoot into us again. Like, this, all this barrier hopping has actually led to us taking a lot of damage, because Reaper fires a lot faster than Roadhog does, so he's just getting shots in while we're barrier hopping, when we could just be, like, shuffling away from him, because he was really far away from us, and we're, like, backing up into our team. But, like, this fight now is basically starting to go downhill really fast, because a lot of our team has been picked off. Like, Mercy got picked off somewhere behind us. It's just, it's all falling apart. Reaper's pushing into, like, you and Zarya, so it's just going to be really hard. And we end up losing the point. So, now, our team is, like, kind of pushing in when they shouldn't be pushing in. Should be waiting for everyone to get back. Genji gets picked off right as we return, so now we just have to wait even longer for Genji to get back. Enemy team's starting to overextend, but it's kind of hard for us to punish them. Like, Roadhog missed his hook, so that's, like, one of the main ways we punish them. And, like, our charge is on cooldown. We also have to be really careful when we charge here, because we're about to charge into a lot of things that can fuck us up. So, Mercy manages to get away with her life. We should really just be holding the barrier up a lot sooner right there, just, like, trying to get our team out. We tried to charge the ulting Winston, don't quite get it, unfortunate. We get a good Graviton off here. I think it's good discipline to not Earth Shatter into this Graviton, because, like, we get it right here. But, like, enemy team is pretty fucked up basically immediately on it. Like, they're getting fucked up. Like, we've got a Pharah shooting into it. We've got Rosaria right-clicking into it. They get fucked up really fast. And now, Mercy's come in with the res, but we still have Earth Shatter. So we can actually Earth Shatter these people, but we don't take it. Like, this is a fine Earth Shatter to go for, and I was like, oh, this is perfect, because you start coming over this way, and I'm like, oh, we can ult them as soon as they're vulnerable. And I think you're afraid that you're not going to get both of the tanks with it, because they're kind of far apart. But, like, bare minimum, you'll get, like, one of the tanks and the Mercy behind them. That's fine, because we're already winning this fight. We just want to keep winning the fight. If we can immediately kill, like, a tank and Mercy, that's great. Or, if nothing else, right, you could say to yourself, this is a Zarya that just got resurrected, so she has no charge right now. So, we could just, like, aim it so that we get Roadhog, and we can just kill Roadhog immediately, because we'll, like, pin him into the wall and focus him down with our team, and then that's one of the biggest, like, threats on their team dealt with, because Roadhog is a really big threat on their team, because the rest of their team is, like, Zarya, Winston, Mercy, you know. So, like, Roadhog is one of the biggest threats, so if we just kill Roadhog really quickly with the Earth Shatter, that'd be fine as well. Instead, we hold the Earth Shatter when we could have gone for a perfectly fine Earth Shatter. Reaper overextends, gets killed, gets caught out. We're swinging into this Zarya. We should probably just be, like, holding the shield up, like, this entire time. Because it's, like, kind of difficult for Reinhardt to kill Zarya. And, like, during this time, like, Roadhog is still alive. He's, like, behind us right now. We could just be holding the barrier up to the rest of their team and just let our team finish off this Zarya. Because Reinhardt, if you don't pin Zarya, is actually, like, kind of bad at killing her, because, like, her barrier blocks a lot of his damage. You know, it's kind of awkward for us to kill her. and we could just be protecting our team from their team during this time. We get her in the end, that's great. We take a significantly worse Earth Shatter in this situation, because, like, there's nothing we're gonna hit with this. Like, we ult in, and, like, I think the thought is that we see, like, kind of a congregation of people in there, because, like, we see, like, their Lucio Dash is in, and their Mercy is there, and their Reaper, Roadhog is there. The thing is, though, we're ulting into this narrow doorway, and Earthshatter gets really finicky around corners, so it's, like, really unlikely we're actually gonna hit these people, because they're so close to corners. And, like, we end up, and, like, Mercy gets hooked as well. And, like, one of them is Lucio. Lucio is gonna be so fucking gone by the time we Earthshatter on reaction like that. And we end up not even getting the Roadhog, so we end up Earthshattering nothing. But if we Earthshattered earlier, we could have killed maybe three people, but at least, like, two people or Roadhog, and Roadhog is, like, the most threatening member of their team. And instead, we Earthshatter nothing, which is really sad. So, we're beating up on the Winston right now. Winston flings himself off, very sad. Again, we've kind of left our team behind, but Mercy's got the res, so it's perfectly fine. And we were, like, beating up on Winston, which Reinhardt wants to do, because, like, he's really good at beating up a Winston, because Winston can't hide in the bubble, you know, things like that. And now we're just cleaning up the fight, because this has, like, been a really extended and scattered fight, but we're finally starting to get a hold in on the point, and we're starting to just pick people off. Great. Farah, like, wastes Barrage over here. Like, the fight's already done. She ults these two people that are, like, not gonna fight us anymore, so that's just kind of, like, throwing it away. And, like, we have Zarya! Fucking save that Barrage and get play of the game later on, right? Like, just a waste of a Barrage. The fight's already done at that point, but whatever, we can't control Farah. So, we're really close to Earthshatter right now, that's great, especially since we know, like, we have Graviton up as well, you know, all these things, it's great. So we want to try and build that as soon as possible. Enemy team's regrouping right now. Lucio drops the beat pretty early, seems like a bit of a panic reaction to them coming in, but whatever. And we got Earthshatter right now. We don't want to Earthshatter right now, though. Good discipline, just, like, spin around in the bubble trying to block some spin around in the Graviton, just trying to block damage instead of charging out like a lot of people would have. Not the greatest Earthshatter. Seems like a bit of a panicked Earthshatter. It's really hard to, like, get a good Earthshatter off in, like, a hectic melee like this, because, like, look at all this shit that's happening right now. We got, like, a Winston ulting around, throwing people around, we got a Lucio bouncing around, we got a Zarya coming around, bubbling people. Like, it's really chaotic, hard to get a good Earthshatter off. Like, we aimed over here, like, we aim it basically squarely at Zarya, I think, expecting Lucio to come forward, but, like, look at all the people we could have gotten over here. This would have been much better if we aimed it a little bit further to the left, but aim better is not helpful advice. So, like, we get really fixated on the Zarya during this fight. Like, we just barely don't kill her, and we end up, like, chasing after her the entire time. And, like, she's getting healed by Mercy. It's hard for Reinhardt to kill Zarya. We end up kind of bumping her away with that shot, which is just really unfortunate. Like, we end up not killing her, but we fixate on her so much that we're just, like, letting our team kind of get killed around us. Like, a lot of stuff is happening here that we're just kind of not helping with, because we're so fixated on Zarya. So, like, we do this. And, like, really, we should be going for something other than, like, we've knocked Zarya down. You feel obligated to pin the Zarya because you've knocked her down, and you feel like it should be an easy kill. And, like, yeah, but, like, she ends up getting away. As soon as, like, Mercy starts healing her and we bump her away, like, we gotta start focusing on something else. Because at that point, it's getting too difficult for us to kill her. Because, like, we bump her away, she's out of range, we're not gonna catch her. And, like, look at everything else that's happening. Like, we can be helping with this over here. We've pinned Zarya, so we can't really stop that. But we can try and block some of the whole hog. We could be trying to focus down the supports, who are just, like, running around pretty much uncontested up until this point. Like, it's a bad Earthshatter that leads to us making a lot of bad follow-up decisions where we just focus on this person we're not killing. Like, we needed to just call it off as soon as we didn't, like, we bumped her away. So, now, we're waiting for our team to regroup. Great, again, I don't like that we're looking over here. I think we should be looking over here a bit more often just in case, like, someone, like, Roadhog comes around to hook us, you know? We don't want to get hooked into the enemy team. So we do have to get in there pretty fast, because the enemy team is, like, getting close to 100%. Roadhog manages to pick someone off. Well, theoretically, like, he gets bubbled and he ends up getting saved. This is a lot happens right here. We don't really need to hold the barrier up right here because we're standing in front of them. It's a narrow doorway, and their team is things like Winston, so it's like we're not really blocking anything with Soldier with the right click, so it's fine that we're swinging into them. Don't really need to Earth Shatter into it either because, like, we're so, like, perfectly set up to, like, just do it without, so I think we play this perfectly fine. Now, we've wiped the enemy team. We've got Earth Shatter if anyone starts coming back, so now we've gotten the point. Great. Awesome. And we're pretty set up for the next fight, because we've got Earth Shatter, we've got Rez, and we've got Whole Hog. So, we've got a lot of things to work with when the enemy team starts pushing in again. And the enemy team's only really going to have time for one more good push, because we only need 25%. So we're feeling pretty good about ourselves right now. And we could have, like, I think it's good that you didn't Earth Shatter, like, because I would have been really tempted in this situation to Earth Shatter into the enemy team right there, because I'll just, like, if YouTube agrees. We can see, like, a lot of people funneling through the narrow choke, and, like, Zarya's bubble breaks, but then, like, we would have probably got cock-blocked by Winston, so it's good to not Earth Shatter into that, because I think I would have Earth Shattered into that if I saw that. So, we end up getting most of the team again. This is a really good Earth Shatter, but once again, we haven't gotten Mercy in the Earth Shatter, because Mercy is her positioning isn't great right here, but she's positioning well enough to not get hit by the Earth Shatter. So, we get the Earth Shatter in, and we get, like, the entire team, but, like, pay attention to Mercy's beam. She is right around this fucking corner. Like, she is right fucking here. And where is she gonna go if we turn around the corner and just start hitting her right now? She's gonna go fucking nowhere, and we're gonna kill her. Like, again, we come into all these people, and, like, we pin a Lucio, who's basically dead. Like, our team is gonna focus these people down. But, like, it doesn't matter if we kill these people if Mercy is still alive, because she's just gonna res them. So, again, we need to, like, focus the Mercy, because she was really close to us, and we didn't get her in the Earth Shatter. So, now, our team is doing some work without us. I think Mercy gets her res off here. Yes, Mercy has indeed resed our team. Enemy team is, like, it's a bit of a chaotic, scattered fight at this point. We've gotten some kills already. Things are going well. Mercy doesn't have a res. Farah gets barrage, kills a bunch of people. Great. Now we just gotta clean up the rest of them. Should be focusing Mercy. Just hold the barrier up. Protect people. Make sure no one dies. Great. Starts whole hogging. Block the whole hog. Great. Getting pushed around a little bit. You know, that just kind of happens with whole hog. Now we just want to start swinging into people. Our whole team's here. They're, like, still a real sick bump just happened over there. You got Mercy and Roadhog, which is great. Graviton again. Just swing into everybody. Great. Cleaned it up. Bam. We got a new Shatter at the end. Didn't even need it. Great. And that's the end of the video. We don't get to see the play of the game. Oh, very sad. Or any of the cards. But, you know, overall, pretty good Reinhardt game. I do think that your prioritization after Earth-shattering people is a little bit off, just because, like, if you don't get them, like, the Mercy is the highest priority, because it doesn't matter if you kill them in the Earth-shatter. If Mercy's still alive, she's going to res everybody, so we have to make Mercy a higher priority in that kind of situation. And it's like, if we Earth-shattered their team, it's like, yeah, we want to hit the enemy team. But, like, they also can't protect Mercy if they've been Earth-shattered. So if we're in a range where we can get to Mercy after Earth-shattering, we should get the Mercy. And we were in a position to do that at, like, a lot of points during this game. So that's that. So there's that. A lot of there were quite a few not great charges as well. Like, a few charges directly led to us dying. And it's really easy to do that as Reinhardt, because it's just like, you want to push shift. You got your pinky finger on the shift button, and you just want to push the shift button, because you're like, I want to pin someone and do 300 damage. But you got to be patient. You got to have a good reason to charge into the enemy team. And, like, the good reason is usually just you are nano-boosted, are going to get nano-boosted, or you've Earth-shattered the team, or, like, there's a Graviton, right? Like, those are pretty much the reasons to charge into someone, unless, like, someone's just drastically out of position. So, like, we need to be a bit more careful when we charge into people. And, prioritize, like, building ult a little bit more with the Fire Strike, because there were a few points where we could have built up Fire Strike right before pivotal team fights, but we ended up building it during the middle of the team fight, which is a lot less helpful than if we have it right at the start of the fight. So, you know, a lot of small, like, optimizations, I would say, but no particularly, like, glaringly huge issues. Just, like, some focus and, yeah. Well, okay, like, the bigger thing was, like, during the second point, we left our team behind a lot to go and fight people. Like, if you're playing Reinhardt, you do have to accept that, like, you don't get to do a lot of the damage, you just have to, like, block a lot of damage for people instead. So that's also something to work on. Trying to, instead of having the mindset of, I have to go in there and get the damage done, trying to work more on the mindset of, I'll protect my team so that they can kill their team, right? Because, like, you're a pretty high SR, you can rely on your team to reason, like, kill the enemy team with reasonable, like, consistency if you're protecting them. So, that's it. That's about it. So, thank you for watching this video if you did. I hope you found it helpful, in spite of all the rambling and, like, deciding I was completely wrong, like, halfway through. You know, that's fine. Hope you found it helpful.